Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to show you the cutout animation tools made by Andreas Esau. This is a Blender add-on that adds a set of tools to make it easy to do 2D modular animation. I had the opportunity to try it out while it was in development, and I must say this is a great replacement tool for spine or creature or even sprite or anything. It is completely free, open source, and so is Blender. This tool mainly makes it easy to rig, to skin, to import, export your cutout animations. To animate, you are still going to use Blender's Dope Sheet and Graph Editor. You benefit from Blender's Mature Animation Toolset, which is great for professionals. This video is not a tutorial, it's just an overview. I really wanted to talk about this tool because this is the only one I know that's completely open source and that's feature complete for professional 2D game animation. This is a tool I'm going to use and I know that many people among you will love it. Let's now look at the tool itself. It comes with a Photoshop script to quickly export all of your character's body parts and to then easily import them in Blender correctly named and placed in space. The script trims and saves selected layers to PNG files. It also generates a JSON file to import your sprites in Blender. You can create a sprite sheet with multiple sprites by adding the --sprite suffix to a layer group's name. This is something you will want to do whenever you have multiple variations of the same sprite. If you put a folder as a prefix in your sprite name, the script will automatically export the corresponding asset to that subfolder, but you must ensure that the folder already exists, otherwise you will get an error. The tool will only export selected layers. Sometimes there are layers you don't want to export, but that you do want to keep in your Photoshop file. I recommend that you tag the layers you want to export with a color. You just have to right-click on the visibility icon to do that in Photoshop. Then, in the Layers panel, you can use color filtering to only show the layers you want to export. You then have to select them all with the Ctrl-Alt-A keyboard shortcut and run the script. This is the fastest way I found so far to do my exports. Right now, there is only an exporter for Photoshop, but the Krita Foundation is working on a tool to export characters to Sprite, another animation application. So we might see an exporter for Krita eventually. Once we have exported our sprites, we can import them in Blender. In the 3D view in Blender, once you have installed and activated the add-on, you will find a new tool category. It is called Cutout Animation. By default, it gives you the option to switch between a 2D and a 3D view, to quickly create an orthographic camera, and to create a new sprite object, which is going to be the container for your character. Once you have a sprite object selected, you can import your character. You just have to navigate to the JSON file that was exported from Photoshop and double-click it to automatically import everything. This import option is very useful beyond 2D game animation. I use it for motion design. That's how I made the animated parts in my Kickstarter trailer. The add-on also allows you to quickly animate the opacity of your sprites, which is pretty tedious to set up in Blender normally. Now we have imported our sprites, the outliner gets populated with our character's body parts. You can quickly select any of them by clicking on the name. You can shift-click to select a range of sprites or elements, and you can control-click to add or remove sprites to your selection. This outliner allows you to quickly turn the visibility on and off and make assets selectable or not. Also notice that it features a search bar with a favorite tag to quickly filter items in the hierarchy. The add-on features a variety of modes that are based on Blender's native creation tools, but that add a few functions to it. First of all, you have the Create Armature mode. There you can create and extrude bones like normal. With one difference, you can see that the 3D cursor always follows your mouse cursor. When you click and drag in that mode, you create a new bone. Another feature it adds to Blender is the ability to parent sprites to bones. You just have to hold the Alt key with a bone or multiple bones selected, and to pick the sprites you want to parent. As far as rigging is concerned, you can use all of Blender's bone-based rigging tools, but the add-on gives you two shortcuts when you select a bone in pose mode. Thanks to these, you can either create an inverse kinematic control or a stretch bone control. The inverse kinematic shortcut will set your active bone to the IK controller, and I recommend that you select the whole chain of bone that has to be affected by this IK controller as well. Let's move on. There are two more things I want to touch on, which are meshing and skinning. Those two modes are available whenever you select a sprite. The meshing tool allows you to draw vertices around your sprite using some kind of brush. And then you can select the outline you drew and triangulate it and unwrap it automatically. The generated mesh can be skinned and bound to multiple bones at once in order to have smooth deformations on your character's limbs. The skin mode uses Blender's native skin tool. The only difference is that it isolates the selected mesh, which is very handy. One last thing, you have to use the built-in collections outliner to create new animations for the tool to properly export them. And then you have an export button which allows you to export all of your animation to a JSON format, and the add-on comes with a Godot script to import everything in the Godot game engine. There are a few more subtleties and functions of the add-on I didn't touch on because the documentation is still in the making right now, so I'm sending you over to Andreas Esau's YouTube channel and his GitHub page to get the add-on and to find tutorials eventually.